Good morning, everyone. We will continue our hydraulic machines. Since the explanation takes a lot of time, so I cannot include everything in a single video. So in last video, we have seen about hydraulic press. Now in our next application of Pascal's law is hydraulic jack, which I have already explained you. And now you know the basic concept or principle. So now it will be easy for you. You see here hydraulic jack, as you know, it is used to raise any very heavy object, for example car or truck or your bike, especially on the service centers. So this is the platform where your vehicle will be standing. If it is car, then let be car. If it is bike, then let be bike, whatever it is. So it also works on the same concept of the Pascal. That means here we have only one valve, that is V. One valve we are having. Again, we will have two cylinders, one cylinder P and one cylinder Q. Here the cylinder P is having area A1, and here the area of Q is more than P, that is A2. Here let the force be F1 and here let the force be F2. Concept you already know. With the help of this handle, if you will exert a small force or pressure on this cylinder P, then that pressure will be transmitted to Q. Here we are having one valve, but here when the pressure will increase, then due to increase in pressure, the valve will open and the pressure will be able to transmit it to Q. So that small force which you have applied here on this small piston, small cylinder Q, that small force has been converted into larger force. That small force will exert here a large force which will raise the vehicle which is standing on this platform, whatever it is. Whenever your work finishes, then you move this handle in the upward direction, due to which the pressure, the liquid will move from here to here and pressure inside the Q will decrease and this platform or your car will come here again back after servicing. So here nothing much, same things which we have learnt in the last class, same are here. If you will apply a small force on the smaller cylinder, that force will be converted into a large force at the larger cylinder. Our next example is hydraulic brakes. In book, only one diagram is given. Generally, we know that any vehicle can have two wheels or four wheels accordingly. But here, the working of one is given and rest of the wheels has same working. Okay, so here again, we have two cylinders. One is P and one is Q. And a liquid is filled here. Generally, it's a kind of OF, just from the viscosity point of view, because we cannot fill here water in much amount. So here one oil is filled between P and Q. P is the smaller smaller cylinder, Q is the larger cylinder. But here at Q, two pistons we have kept, B1 and B2. You can name them P1 and P2 also. Here we have one piston only and here we have two pistons. Pistons. Generally, till now, whatever we have learnt, we had only one piston in P and one in Q. But here we have two pistons and then we have brake shoes, that you know, due to which we are able to apply the brakes. And here we have one spring and this brake shoes are connected with the upper layer of the rim, and both this one and this are the parts of rim only, okay, of the tire, or you can say wheel. So first of all, the concept starts from here itself. With the help of foot pedal, we apply the brake. So we apply a small amount of pressure, or you can say force, on the smaller cylinder P. And then that pressure will be exerted or transmitted to Q, larger cylinder. Here, the small amount of force which has been applied is converted here into large amount of force. And these forces applied, that means this force has been increased here, pressure has been increased here in Q. Increased means due to the transmitted pressure, more amount of force has been applied on the boundaries of the Q. I'm not saying that at the points the pressure is different, but due to some amount of applied pressure, some extra pressure has been reached here. That is the same pressure which you have applied here. and that will exert force on these boundaries, and these boundaries are right now pistons, so they can move away. So as soon as the pressure will be applied on B1 and B2, they will move away. That means they can expand here. They cannot expand, but they will displace from their side in the outward direction, and here also outward direction. And that force on these pistons will exert force on both of these brake shoes. Okay, because of which the brake shoes will move in the outward position, and they will, and this spring will contract, and they tie this rim with them. That means they resist the motion of the rim. Your wheel is moving because rim is moving. So if anyhow you can seize the motion of rim, then your wheel will also stop. That means the motion of the wheel will also stop. So that extra pressure will move this piston B1 and B2 in outward position, which will exert pressure or force on the brake shoes, because of which the brake shoes move outward and seizes the motion of the rim. And as well as the motion will cease, that means the motion of the rim will cease, that means your wheel will cease and you are able to apply the brake. As soon as you will remove this external force or pressure from the foot pedal, that means as soon as you will release the brakes, similarly at the same time the pressure will be released and both the brake shoes as well as the pistons will come back to their normal position, and again your wheel will be in the state of working. That means as soon as you will apply pressure, or as soon as you will accelerate your vehicle, it will move. Along with that, we have one more concept here that is related with mechanical advantage. So right now we have seen some working. And in all those working, we have observed that we are applying a small force and we are getting a large force as output. This is our input, because this is we are applying, and this is our output because we are getting it. So we are saying that we are applying only a small amount of force and we are getting a large amount of force. That means our all these hydraulic machines work as force multiplier. Multiplier means it multiplies the force which you are applying, or you can say which increase the force which you are applying. If you are applying 10 Newton force, then it increase it 10 times and doing it to 100 Newton. That means this hydraulic machine work as force multiplier, and for the machines which act as force multiplier, mechanical advantage is greater than 1 and velocity ratio is greater than 1. These two terms we will read in detail in next class. But right now, this mechanical advantage is actually load upon effort. Effort means the force which you are applying. Load means the output which you are getting. So you are saying that I am applying a small amount of force and I am getting large output. That means this value is more. Load is more. Suppose it is 5 and this value is less. So ultimately you will get an answer greater than 1. And when the mechanical advantage is greater than 1, that machine acts as force multiplier. Simply, velocity ratio is the ratio of velocities of effort. Velocities of effort upon velocities of load, or you can say displacement of effort upon displacement of load, and that also comes to be more than 1. That's why again here velocity ratio is greater than 1 and it acts as a force multiplier. Rest of the things we will see in the next class. Thank you.